I was thinking to present what is now in the model code 2020 in the draft, although Steiner has addressed, has advanced some of what is there, and my presentation will be also short. It will be about the definition, about what is now included in the levels of approximation for the different levels for just assessing or designing the service life, and examples of durability indicator, how they are in the present draft of the model code. For me, and this is personal, I was addressing this subject many years ago, and in particular from the beginning of the 90s, because in Spain it was introduced the penetration, the maximum penetration depth of water in the concrete, in the code. And in that case, that was an additional test for the marine exposure classes. And well, I was not in favor of that test, and I proposed at that time to substitute by the resistivity. But in any case, it was my just started my interest for the what is an indicator. And this is my personal summary that I think that some of you have said more or less the same, but well, I had that written. Indicator can be any characteristic of the concrete that has been said also by Kefei Lee, and has to be some characteristic that should be related to a property. That is clear. But when we are talking about durability, and we need to precise, because as has been said by you, by some of you, it has to be related to the service life or to the durability. In that case, for me, it has to be related, the selection has to be related with one limit state. And the word limit state has not been said exactly so, but Steiner has said, in the same conceptual idea, you need to recover depth and also the probability of failure. That is the function limit state is there. I mean, we may have different indicators for different limit states, because that limit is what you like to monitor or to follow. The other is a property that can be measured, as has been said. In my case, I prefer a non-destructive monitoring, because that there you can monitor in the structure, not only the material, but in the structure. The resistivity can be measured in both cases. And it has to be to have clear limits, as, for instance, has been presented by Veronique, or by Roberto, by Mark, limiting values that can be categorized and used for alarms or for classification. And this, I will say later on, is to distinguish with the modeling, because in the modeling, you calculate the precise value. But here, if we are in the design phase, or we have a existing structure, is helpful from the engineering point of view to have categories, not only exact values and the model. They can be of two types, and we call direct when it can be used in time explicit models, as has been presented by Veronique or Roberto or Mark. That means that the indicator can be used for the other level of approximation, that is modeling, or is indirect. In that case, you use categorizing, but with no time explicit model. And this is also valid, can be indirect there. And also we have indicators at the material level or at the structural level. I can remember when preparing indicators for harbors, for instance, for the caissons of harbors, that we decided that the main limit state is the inclination of the caisson. In that case, at the structural level, was used an inclinometer, and that was more critical than any of the durability aspects that we were commenting. And this is what Maria Pina and Alfred have well illustrated as being in Commission 3, that is existing structures. You have been talking, Maria Pina, you say local and global. I understand more material or structure level. But in any case, this is what. Now I go to the how is now in the model code, and this is one of our objectives for the future, to know what we have in the draft and look at, after this discussion, if we need to update or to improve this, what is now in the draft. In the draft now, it has been presented by Steiner. We have an introduction, and there is for the verification of limit states associated with durability. And we have these levels of approximation, the five, the concrete composition. And there I would like to mention a point that was discussed precisely due to Steiner's questions. And we decided to call the first level concrete composition and not deemed to satisfy, because he was right. The indicators are also a deemed to satisfy condition. In that case, why not to mix the two levels? Well, we split it because we thought that one is the concrete composition, and the level two could be this performance or durability indicator that you can, is an additional test. Is not only the composition of the concrete or a prescription, but is an additional test, and we separated. After we have the level three and level four and the avoidance of deterioration. As I have the, how is now in a drone, in a graph in the model code, here we have how we have split it, that is as prescriptive of performance. Prescriptive is only the old system or the present system, is not all. Almost all codes in the world, they still have these prescriptive rules on the concrete composition, the crack limit, and so on. And this is prescriptive. And after we have performance-based approach for durability design or assessment, and there we have rules by test and measurement, and we call that the durability indicators, the level two. Or we may have the models, as have been presented today, as physical or empirical models. They don't need to be only physical. And with the performance test, we can go to a semi-probabilistic or partial safety factor verification, or a full probabilistic. And we have the other possibilities to avoid damage from the beginning by using non-vulnerable materials or by separating the environmental actions from the concrete by membranes or whatever. In that case, just this one, that in the design chapters, we have all of these levels separated, and for the initiation period and for the propagation period. And they are also applied to all durability, all possible attacks, durability problems, all possible attacks. But we have models in the model code, only physical empirical models for corrosion, for carbonation and chloride-induced corrosion, not for freeze and thaw or for sulfate attack. In that case, we have some composition or rules or indicators for all deterioration mechanisms that are not corrosion, additional physical models for corrosion, and avoidance of damage for all of them. And as I said, we have the level one, the level three and four, and what is the object of this workshop, that is the level two. And for the level two, in the commentary part of this general introduction that is here and that was shown also by Steiner, he said that the target reliability levels for condition limit state gives the basis for verifying the subsection, because we have in the model code, we have a chapter for the verification or for the assessment, that means with all models, and we have other chapter, that is the 27, we have other chapter for the input parameters, how to introduce the input parameters in these models, that is the material characteristics. And in this chapter, that is now chapter 14, with the material characteristic or with the material properties, we have the description of how to fulfill all the levels in the chapter of models. And is said at traditional, national, international level, well, the prescriptive or the avoidance of deterioration. And the another concept related to the verification of limit steps has been associated to the so-called torture test, that is also the base of the durability the indicators. And so, I mean, also we have the equivalent durability concept that can be used when comparing a concrete with known performance with a concrete with not known performance. In that case, in the commentary, it has been tried to summarize all previous approaches for the durability design, not only for the modeling, but also for the concrete composition and for the durability indicators. And in the in this chapter, that is 27, that is dealing with modeling, and in that case, for explaining how to assess with performance indicators, it said precisely that all the concrete characteristics or properties can be assessed as indicators of the resistance to carbonation. I select the carbonation instead of chlorides, but in the case of chloride-induced corrosion, is the same. When specifying them, the definition, limits, and scope should be clearly stated. This we said because we thought that still we have not a common approach. In that case, we cannot close to just suggest a few or very specific indicators. It's better to open the possibilities the first time that in the model code will be used this concept. In that case, to open the possibility that there are several type of indicators, and in that case, what any prescriber should be clear in the definition, limits, and scope. And there I mention what has been said by Mark, by Roberto, and by Steiner on all the details, not only 1,000 coulombs or 2,000 coulombs, but which cover depth, which probability, all has to be specified. The values of the indicator shall be linked to a exposure class, and it can be mentioned the carbonation rate, the porosity that was mentioned by Veronique, or pH indicator for the carbonation. And that is carbonation, sorry, the example. And the carbonation rate threshold value depends on the cover depth. That is thinking in that about the coulombs that I said. Also about the water porosity and the pH indicator. And in the left, in the part of commentary, because it's only indication, is not, let's say, normative, it's more informative, it is said that other indicators can be used, for instance, the air or oxygen permeability, the buffering capacity, that is the calcium hydroxide that has been mentioned by Veronique, water sortivity, electrical resistivity, and, well, there are several indications about the testing methods there. And this is a photocopy or a copy from the text. Well, it has been said here. We have in this point that will be the performance indicator, that is the level of approximation. Two, there we have this type of explanation, as I said, there, and also the commentaries, some commentaries, and this is related with that. And in that case, it's also because if they are used, some models, they have to be used with partial safety factor, or themselves, they can be used with partial safety factors. That means which is the error, the expected error, you can multiply by a partial safety factor in order to compensate by the uncertainty. And, well, my final slide is we need to reach an agreement on the definition of durability indicator. It's not obligatory, but our aim is to improve present version of Model Code 2020. In that case, we need to discuss this in Commission 3 and Commission 8. And as the version, the present version of the Model Code 2020, the draft, will be distributed for opinion of all members, the suggestion need to arrive to the writers, to the editorial panel in order to correct to the extent the present version of the model code. I think that all the approaches presented here are coherent with what is there. Perhaps what has been presented by Commission 3, that is Alfred and Maria Pina, is beyond, is more wider than what we have. But in my opinion, the assessment of a 16 structure is not still completely finished or can be much more improved in present version of model code 2020. And I think that this is why the whole approach they presented is not fully incorporated with the structural level all about, or maybe Alfred will correct me because they have incorporated in the other chapters. I think that it's very important not mixing the decision of having this level of approximation with a possible listing of characteristics that might be durability indicators, because this, in my opinion, need to evolve. We need to have the experience, more experience. Just has mentioned, I think that they are used in engineering world, but maybe we need more experience with that. And also the adoption of a definition specifically for this model code should not prevent individual authors to use other definitions in their works on their own, because we need not to close any door, always to have opened the door for innovations. And we think that this is a big innovation, but maybe they could come other innovations later that could correct our approach now. And this is all. Thank you for your attention.